Hello, I'm Muffy St. Pierre Radwell, and I am so, so thankful for my husband, Brad. And also that I'm starting my very own new clothing line, and it's—
Hey, everyone. I'm Brad Radwell.
Oh, no, no! Too chunky to wear that outfit! Yeah?
No, no.
Have a seat.
I can't stay.
Suit yourself.
Neither can you. I need your help to kill that thing.
The Navy squids and half the world are out there chasing that thing. You don't need my help. It'll be dead by morning.
Then so will we. I tried to tell you. The shark's infected.
Infected?
Radiation in its DNA that basically turns it into a biological atomic bomb. If it goes off anywhere near land, the whole Southern California coast will be uninhabitable for the next 20,000 years.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that, but you'll have to find yourself another captain.
Dad! Divorce is always hard on kids.
It's hard on everyone.
You left. I wanted to believe you, but you left. So I believed the person that was there for me. You are all that I have left. Why won't you just help me?
When do you want to leave?
Does right now work?
You got a plan?
Kind of involves blowing up your boat.
Perfect.
Reese, what the hell are you doing? We have to get these people off the beach.
Because of a gas explosion in a restaurant?
There was no gas explosion.
Tell that to the fire marshal.
You know damn well he's not going to listen to me.
Who would? Spouting all that BS about nuclear radiation.
It's the truth, and you know it.
That makes restaurants go boom.
It happened.
We saw it, man.
Why are you here? I thought I fired you.
What about all the dead fish I've been reporting to you?
You mean the fish that were burnt to death during that parasailing fire?
That's not what caused it.
Then what did? Is there an atomic jellyfish
it's
on the loose?
It's a shark.
Well, the apple doesn't fall too far from the tree now, does it?
Oh, Gina's got you down, Reese. Oh, you go down, Reese. You down. Put him in the armbar, Gina.
Armbar, bitch.
Oh, Reese, you down. You better tap, baby. You better tap. Oh, that's it. Gina won the fight. Ding, ding, ding.
Come on. Gina. 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 Come on. Gina DeLamo wins this fight easy. King Kong ain't got nothing on Gina DeLamo. Greatest of all time.
Woo-hoo! Hey, Miss Larkin. Hey, Jerry.
Hey, Belinda. How are you?
Guess what? I just got elected co-captain of the cheerleaders.
Congratulations. That's real fun.
That's good, Belinda.
Thanks, Jerry. Oh, hey, how are the berries going to be this year?
Just fine.
You're late, Miss Pie.
How many times have I told you? Please do not call me that. I'm fat and I know it, but I would appreciate you not drawing attention to it. What in the world are you doing out here?
Nina brought me out here before she left. I was sore. You'd show up before the rain. No, don't do that! I want to hear the rain!
I would appreciate some thanks. I just saved you from your watery grave, Daddy.
What do you want, myself?
Oh, why don't I just go see what Nathan wants?
Come
take care of
your daddy until I get back.
Take him with you. I don't have anything to say to him.
I'm gonna go find Mark.
Guess what?
Not now, honey.
Okay. You bit me all over. Now I'm gonna go and have to tell Daddy I got trapped under a 10-girl pyramid.
Your daddy's never gonna see all them bruises.
Well, somebody else might.
You better be making a joke. If I find out that it's true, headlines are gonna reach here, lead us mother to death with her own pom poms.
I was only kidding, but now I won't be able to wear a bathing suit for the next 5 days and 4 nights.
What time you suppose it's getting to be?
I don't know. I suppose. Hey!
Where is it?
Something dripped on me. It's just water, I guess, but...
Damn it, Bolin!
There is something up in that tree!
Yeah. There's no one in that tree.
There was someone up there.
Hey, what did it look like then?
It looked like a woman.
There's nothing in that tree. It's so dim in here that moss could look like anything you wanted to.
I don't care if you believe me or not, but I would appreciate it to no end if you put down that bottle of bourbon and get me out of here.
Just listen. There's nothing there. You just got to
stop. Damn it, Nathan, you were just as scared as I was.
No, I wasn't. Now go on. Go on, I'll be right behind you. But don't start off until I get in the scout and get it started. Do you hear me?
Okay.
Yeah?
Okay.
Sorry. Come on, let's go back out by the pool. We've been for a while.
Oh. I'm sorry, but I just couldn't live with myself if I didn't do that. I just had to get you back. But I promise I'll be good to you for the rest of the evening.
You were off the hook. What a voice. Really? Oh, are you sure? I felt just a little bit, just a little hoarse tonight.
You stole my voice.
Your voice? But I can hear you just fine. I mean, are you sure it's not your hearing that's the problem?
My singing voice.
Ah, welcome to my world.
I'm calling security.
No, it's okay. It's okay. I think she's just a little bit drunk.
I am not drunk.
Sweetie, it's okay. Look, I too had a drug and alcohol problem.
Wow, me too. Really?
Ugh. See, it's okay. It's okay. Look, maybe you guys, can I talk to her alone?
Of course.
You guys are the best.
God, she's so awesome.
I'm gonna ask her to be my sponsor.
How did you get my track?
Eddie gave it to me, among other things.
You're a liar. Eddie told me I was just enhancing your vocals.
Oh, well, you know boys. They'll say whatever they have to say to get things from us girls. Oh, let me guess. He promised you a record deal, and you actually believed him.
Why wouldn't I? He can make you a recording star. Imagine what he can do with me.
Oh, sweetie, I know exactly what he's gonna do with you.
I'm gonna tell the world about this.
Oh, go right ahead. No one's gonna believe you. You're a drunk.
I am not a drunk!
Oh, you wanna bet?
Help! Help! She's attacking me! She's threatening me! Help me!
Are you insane? You got to be kidding me! This is a joke! Oh my god!
I was trying to do is just reason with her, and then she just came after
me! Please let me down! Please! She stole my voice! She's a thief! Please call the cops! Thank you.
I scare you? Why are you shaking?
I'm gonna prove it's my voice.
Oh, nobody cares if it's your voice. It's me they want. I mean, I am the one with the money and the fame and the power.
Yeah, all that's missing is the talent.
Well, that's what you're for.
I won't do it.
You don't have a choice. You already signed a contract for life. I mean, besides, being my voice was the greatest thing that ever happened to you. If you really think about it, without me, you're nobody. You are really so lucky. You get to be my voice. Gosh, what more could you want?
This doesn't look suspicious at all, Nicole.
What do you want to know?
Anything you can tell us about Gerard and Derek. What were they involved in together?
Together? Nothing.
They weren't in business?
Gerard and Derek. No, Derek bought from us. Yeah, he was a client, but that's all.
Well, the same person that killed Derek also killed Gerard, so there's got to be a reason. What is it?
Look, Gerard didn't come home Monday night, and I knew that something bad happened. I didn't know what else to do, so I asked Derek for help.
What kind of help?
Well, Derek used to be a cop, right? I mean, I just thought that maybe he could find Gerard.
Derek starts investigating.
And whatever he finds gets him killed.
But Gerard was being stupid. Okay, he started selling to a lot of new people. Like people he didn't know. And when you do that, other dealers get angry.
Okay, so you're talking about a turf war. So what other dealers should we be looking at? Nicole, who is it?
Nicole? We won't let anything happen to you.
You don't know. This guy, he's dangerous. Like really, really dangerous.
I bet you can when we take that bracelet away from you this year.
Cute. But then you'd have to beat us. And that's just not happening.
Like her outfit. Was I talking to you?
Oh, excuse me? No. No time for cat fights, Kayla. As a matter of fact, Kat, why don't you go back to East LA? Just go south, and when you start to smell poverty, you're home.
That was a big bowl of wrong. You're like a stalker. Don't you have anything else, I don't know, better to do? Speaking, aren't you lucky? Not in my worst chair, Mayor. First your mother, and now your little ghetto friends. I'm sorry, but I don't think you're gonna be happy until there's drive-bys and chickens in the front yard. Go back to the barrio where you belong.
You jealous bitch, you ratted us out.
It's a good thing you can't touch me. Because you would be expelled just like your little homegirls.
Oh, don't blame Avery for getting them deported.
One more word from you and I'll herky you in the throat.
It's okay, Kayla. I'll gladly take the credit for clubbing those baby seals.
Hey, Gerella DeVille, there's a big difference between seals and sea lions, you know?
Hey, Goof is on? I don't care. Go post it for your BFF on your fungus-filled Facebook page. And say bye-bye to the Spirit Championships while you're at it. Bye-bye.
Tráelo.
I don't speak Taco Bell menu, so what does that mean? Run away. One compliment, and now you're the expert?
Last I checked, neither of us fell into that category.
Yeah, but you hired me. I didn't hire you.
Maybe you should.
All right, Baryshnikov. Let's get back to reality.
I'll show you, Baryshnikov. You did it again.
Did what?
If you're gonna audition for next semester, you could use a little extra practice.
I think once was enough.
Again.
You kidding me?
Again.
One rejection and you're gonna quit?
I've had plenty more than one, thank you very much.
Okay, but you realize that's what this business is about. Rejection after rejection after rejection.
Thanks for the tip.
You're welcome.
Why haven't you changed your status yet?
What?
Well, we've been dating for like 4 months and your Facebook still says you're single. So what, are you trying to keep your options open or something?
Ash, I haven't been on my Facebook in forever.
Well, you checked into Brickyard last Wednesday. You uploaded pictures on Monday and the weekend before that.
Okay, I've been on.
Okay, well, my friend Billy Moore dated Jennifer for like 6 months. He never changed his status either. Turns out he had two girls on the side, one of which was in Jennifer's class too.
Well, I just don't understand what it is with you guys. I mean, do you think that we're just gonna freak out if you don't do...
It's done.
Oh. Okay, thanks, babe. Bye, love you.
You're not gonna fall asleep on me, are you?
Are you kidding me? I couldn't fall asleep right now if I ate a turkey marinated in NyQuil.
Okay, well, can you keep an eye on me, please?
Yeah, sure.
No, but I'm serious, though.
I got you, baby. Just chill.
Yeah. That's what I'm trying to do.
Chill.
I believe you, Gina. A patient of mine had recurring dreams that there were frogs in her bed. She would bolt upright and pound her fist around the room trying to squash the slimy things. In the end, she broke her hand so many times that they were severely deformed. But it wasn't the frogs that broke her hands. It was her own actions that did it. Just as it's your own actions that are responsible.
No, you're saying I did this?
Oh,
I didn't
no,
this.
Shh. Wait. Why are your pupils dilated?
And we'll be picking you up at 7 p.m. sharp, Miss Clark.
So don't be late.
I won't.
I won't.
Oh, come on. You needed this, okay? Hey, Margo's throwing you the classiest royal wedding any little princess could ask for, okay? You needed some fun for your bachelorette, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Just saying. Oh, hey there. I saw you out there on the floor. Not bad, Mr. McConnell.
Well, thank you, Miss...
Bell.
Like a wedding bell?
I mean, I wouldn't know. I haven't had a relationship longer than 3 months, like, ever.
No? Why not?
Well, because all men are evil. I mean, no offense.
You think I'm evil?
I think you have the potential.
Oh, that's right. Amber told me this is how you flirt.
Oh, no. I mean, if I was flirting, you would know.
So tell me you love me. So tell me you love me.
I was upstairs rehearsing, but I heard the music cranking up down here and kind of got distracted.
Sorry, I just didn't know anybody was here.
I see. It wasn't too dark for me not to see you, though.
Huh. Well, did you, you see anything you liked there?
How do I look? No shine?
You know, if you keep this up, this could be your view full time.
How did you make it into the masterclass? Were they giving out scholarships for the maturity impaired?
By studying your amazing acting skills, of course.
Can I vomit now? Stalker.
Ow! Steve, your guitar. The guitar that you were looking for the scene. It's here. So he's gonna sing a song for us. Mm-hmm. Steve?
Why does he need a guitar?
It's a character choice they made.
Aha, character choice. This is the musical.
Right, but you always say to challenge ourselves, so we're challenging ourselves with singing in a scene right now. Like, remember, like this, like I showed you.
Let's hear it. Your own action.
Well, what beautiful weather we're having here, huh?
Yeah, and it's more beautiful that we're together. It's like Romeo and Juliet.
Yeah.
You know what would make it more beautiful is if we had a passionate kiss.
Right, because talking about the kiss before the kiss makes it so much better.
Yeah. All right, great. Next scene.
Ladies, I'm sorry, you just got here during a bit of a... Ooh, I can see your nipples, officer.
Anything you see will be held against you. I collect stamps.
Like hot stamps?
No. They have to be kept at room temperature to preserve their value. I learned that the hard way. I'm gonna go use the little girl's room. Oh, I'll go with you.
Mr. Worldwide! Christina Aguilera.